skill, not only in English, but in acting, speech, and a whole range of other skills. I feel that it is not for me to talk about how important English is. Of course, it is easy because it is my own language. But that in itself is not enough reason for why English is important. What we have seen today is that English can develop one of the most invaluable skills, that of confidence building. In front of me, I see a whole hall of the future. This has been mentioned a few times in speeches today. For me, it's a great pleasure to look at the future and know that it's in very safe hands. If we think about all the performances that we have seen today, I'd just like to go through them and briefly mention how English has supported the amazing talent. We started off with the primary section of St. John's doing an action song. Not only did they speak and sing beautifully in English, not only did they show great confidence in standing up on this stage in front of us, but they showed another valued commodity, one which I value and I certainly hope is valued in this room, and that is of a community spirit. We then listened to a very famous speech by Mahatma Gandhi, and I have to say, I am truly humbled by the memory of N.Shanmugathasan. If I had that memory, I would be a far more successful person than I am. It truly was awe-inspiring, and you should be incredibly proud. Not only did he speak by memory, but his pronunciation was absolutely exquisite. And as a professional English teacher and trainer, that really is a compliment. We then had the choral recitation, which was truly talented. Again, not only were the students speaking in English, but they were also balancing rhythm, timing, and a range of other skills, all at the same time. We had the dance troupe. I have to say, I thought it was fantastic. I loved the music. I thought the dance moves were great. And what to me was very important was seeing how you can embrace your own culture, not your Sri Lankan culture, your Tamil culture, with that of other cultures. We then had the poetry reading, The Moon, by Robert Louis Stevenson. Again, as I listened, because of the way in which it was said, it was completely engaging, and I actually visualised the animals watching the moon. Then we have the boy band. Brilliant. Brave to be up here in front of everybody and do that, not just in front of your teachers and your parents, but to do it in front of your own peers and friends, I think is truly very brave and shows the level of confidence that you have. And then we had Hamlet. Of course, there is a history of studying Shakespeare in A level. Last week I was working with a group of teachers, some of whom are from St. John's College, at looking at how, when we teach Shakespeare, we can make it more engaging for students. This is quite a difficult thing to do, because the fact is that Shakespeare is a core curriculum text if you're studying A-level English literature. But the real key to it is making it engaging. I think what's very important about Shakespeare is that the themes written so many hundreds of years ago are true today. Not only that, but there are so many social issues that Shakespeare addressed in plays, which are still relevant today. At the end of that act, we heard that Hamlet was a story of broken dreams. And I find that a very pertinent choice here in Jaffna. I've been coming to Sri Lanka for 14 years now. I first came here in 2000 as a tourist. In those days, I wasn't able to come to the north as far as I could get as Anuradhapura. I continued to persist in getting to the north, and I feel very privileged that in 2011 I was able to come here and live, first in the eastern province in Trincomalee, and then about a year later I moved up to Jaffna.